RW Cephei, a K-type hypergiant and a semi-irregular variable star in the constellation Cepheus, and amongst the largest known stars by radius. In the same class as YU Scuti and VY Canis Majoris, just underwent a great dimming event, similar to Betelgeuse. What you will find fascinating is this star is quite far away, about 11,000 to maybe 16,000 light years from Earth. It's a lot like Betelgeuse, both in age and in characteristics, but it's way bigger and more massive. It could be up to twice the size of Betelgeuse, and if it were in our solar system, it would stretch all the way to Jupiter's orbit. That's about 1500 to 1600 times the size of our sun. Interestingly, it's pushing the limits of how big we think stars can be, which is already a bit puzzling. This might be one of the biggest stars in the galaxy, but we're uncertain about its exact size due to uncertainties in distance and star type. In this video, we are going to talk about why red giant stars like Betelgeuse and this RW Cephei are dimming and what does this dimming mean? Is it going supernova? Is our night sky going to look like this very soon? Even before we were able to solve Betelgeuse's dimming properly, this new problem has emerged. Seems like in cosmology, this kind of crisis is happening quite often and we have no idea why it's happening. And what should we get out of this? Scientists have made significant discoveries in recent years, aiming to unravel the mystery of these enigmatic stars, including Betelgeuse. The observations, particularly from a star called RW Cephei, have provided crucial insights, potentially resolving the mystery surrounding the stars once and for all. The study of RW Cephei has identified a definitive cause for the dimming effects that can reduce the star's brightness by up to 75% or more. In December 2022, this star underwent this significant dimming, losing about one-third of its usual brightness. As shown in this image, it even changed shape. Like Betelgeuse, many scientists investigated this event, and we now have more details about these occurrences, which seems to be very similar to both stars. You know, surprisingly, the cause appears to be the same as with Betelgeuse, increased mass load leading to the formation of a large dust cloud. This could create a darker area in front of the star as seen from Earth. Telescopic observations confirmed this, revealing a sizable dark patch on the star's surface resulting from mass ejection. Comparing images, especially from December 2019, the similarities with Betelgeuse are striking. Additional observations by amateur astronomers showed blue shifted lines from hydrogen and potassium, indicating movements towards us at a speed of about 40 km per second. This suggests that the material is rapidly expanding from the star's surface. Since much of this material is cold and dark, it blocks our view of the star. Scientists expect this dimming effect to last several months, possibly longer, due to the star's larger size. While the explanation for RW Cephei's dimming is somewhat similar to Betelgeuse, there are intriguing differences. Unlike Betelgeuse, RW Cephei has undergone such dimming events before, with recent observations showing even more extreme changes in brightness. In 1948 and 1941, similar dimming events occurred, following by a rapid brightening reminiscent of the current observations. RW Cephei, being larger and losing more mass than Betelgeuse, has recently transitioned itself from red supergiant phase to a new one, a hotter phase. The mass loss is a crucial part of this evolutionary phase, representing massive ejection events during the star's transition to the helium burning phase. During this stage, the star is expected to become less luminous, possibly cooler, and may shrink until it exhausts its helium. Observations from the Chara telescope reveals the star's non-round appearance, indicating significant evolutionary process and chaotic surface activity caused by the outer layer's rapid motion. Observations in the visible and infrared light confirm that the fading is more prominent in visible colors, supporting the conclusion that a large dust cloud is responsible for the dimming. As the cloud expands away from the star, normalcy will likely return and persist for several years. However, RW Cephei seems to experience multiple grand eruptions during this transition stage, a common occurrence for red giants. While RW Cephei is undergoing more of these events, Betelgeuse might be at the beginning of such occurrences, hinting that it might go supernova sooner than RW Cephei. Interestingly, a similar phenomenon was observed around VY Canis Majoris, a star that was once considered the largest in the galaxy. Although it's no longer the largest, VY Canis Majoris in a red giant phase like Betelgeuse underwent a comparable process, indicating that such events are quite common for stars in this stage. VY Canis Majoris, likely less advanced than RW Cephei, serves as a prototype for what might happen to Betelgeuse and possibly to VY Canis Majoris in next few centuries. The stars are changing rapidly. The RW Cephei is expected to look drastically different in the coming centuries, potentially becoming challenging to observe as a red giant. The observations suggest that none of these events are unusual or indicative of an imminent supernova. They appear to be normal for red giants. This understanding may even help to solve the mystery of disappearing stars detected in the last 70 years. Perhaps these disappearing stars were red giants and undergoing a dramatic shift, rendering them temporarily invisible. But for us, studying this type of stars is crucial in comprehending the fate of red giants. One day, they may provide answers about when Betelgeuse will go supernova and its potential impact on Earth. Currently, scientists believe it won't have a significant effect, but uncertainties remain. If you wanna know why we are comparing everything to Betelgeuse in this video, then this is the best video to understand everything.